Okay, good evening class again. Today, we're going to present all your inventions depende dun sa inyong grupo na napuntahan. Okay? So let's start from the ancient period. Who would like to present from the ancient period?
Good evening po, sir. Good evening po. Ito po, galing po sa ancient period. Ano po siya? Seismiscope po. Nakikita po ba?
Hindi.
Po, sir, ito po yung isa po sa invention po ng ancient period. Ang tawag po dito ay seismoscope. Seismoscope is an instrument for recording the occurrence or time of an earthquake or detect an earthquake. Each dragon head pointed in different directions, yung north, south, east, and west, and it was cylindrical in shape with 8 dragons. Invented by Sang Cheng noong AD 132. AD po means Anno Domino. Or Latin for in the year of Sang Heng po. Invented po. Okay. Nung na-invent po siya noong AD 132. AD po means Anno Domini. Or Latin word for the year of the Lord. Yun lang po. Thank you po.
Okay, thank you. Next. Thank you, Mr.
Sir, ako po.
Next.
Sir.
Sige. Uy, sino yun?
Lovely
sige,
po.
Lovely.
Yung nakuha ko pong yung Roman ancient period invention po nakuha ko is, nakikita po ba?
Huwag yung malikot para makita natin.
Concrete po yung nakuha kong Roman ancient period invention po. Ito po.
Kita, sige.
Yan.
Proceed.
It is finally durable substance known as opus caementitium or Roman concrete. It is first emerged some 2,100 years ago, and it began with Augustus, the first Roman emperor in 27 BC. So how did they come up with this? The Roman mixed limestone with volcanic ash to form a mortar, then fuck this thick substance together with chunks of brick or volcanic top to form the basic material for roads, bridges, aqueducts, building, and other structure. Yung halimbawa po nitong structure na to is yung sa Pantheon and Coliseum.
Again, what's the title of the invention?
Sir, concrete po.
Concrete. By whom? Who is the inventor?
By Augustus po.
Augustus. Next. Good. Thank you. Next.
Thank you, sir.
It's a concrete by Augustus, ancient period. Next. Thank you, Miss Lovely.
So yung akin po, sir, yung napili ko po invention, yung Baghdad battery po. Yung naka-discovered po sa Baghdad battery po is yung mga Persians noong 250 BC po hanggang 224 AD po. So yung description po ng Baghdad battery, ano po siya? So, Baghdad battery is also known as Persian battery. These artifacts were discovered by German archaeologists during the 1936 excavation of the old village Kujo Trabo near Baghdad. So, tapos yung purpose po tsaka function po niya, wala pa pong exact function yung Baghdad battery po kasi po hanggang ngayon po meron pa po silang debate or hindi pa po, kumbaga may wild guess lang po nila na uri lang po ng battery yung isa lang po siyang type ng battery. Ayun lang po, sir.
So again, the invention is Baghdad battery by?
Persians po, sir.
Persians. Okay.
Persians.
Ancient period. Good. Thank you, Adria. Next.
Ito po, sir.
Yan.
Yung na-search ko po, Clepsydra.
Clepsydra, okay.
Invented siya na, nakikita niyo po ba?
Yes.
Apo. Invented Charles of Ancient Babylonia po siya. Tapos date niya ng 14th century BC po. Before Christ po yung meaning po ng BC. Tapos po yung description niya po, also called po siya ng water clock. Thus, ancient device of measuring time by the gradual flow of water. Were among the earliest timekeepers that did not depend on the observation of celestial body. Dati daw po, noong earliest time po, di po siya dumidepende po dun sa celestial body. Tapos po, how to work clepsydra po. Uses the flow of water to measure the time and inflow water clocks. Works in basically the same way, except instead of flowing out of the container, the water is filling up the marked container. As the container, the observer can see where the water meets the lines and tell how much the much time has passed. Ay lang po.
Okay, again, what is the invention?
Clepsydra po, Clepsydra. Also called water clock po.
Or invented by?
Ano po siya, yung sa na-search ko po talaga, Romans po.
It's the Romans.
Pero po,
okay, okay lang yan. It's the Romans. Okay yan. Next, thank you.
Sir, this is frame heart po, originated in Europe, invented by Finnish people of Western Siberia.
What's
frame
the type?
Heart is a musical instrument po, in which the neck and the sound box are joined by a column or four pillar which braces against the tension of the strings. Ayun po, sir.
What's the title of the invention again?
Frame heart po.
Invented by?
Finnish people of Western Siberia po, sir.
Okay, Western Siberia. Good. Thank you. Next.
Thank you. Ako po.
Next.
Sir, ako po.
Sige, Beatrice.
So, ito po yung papyrus. Papyrus. Or yung sinaunang papel.
Yan, papyrus.
Apo. Na-invento po siya ng mga Egyptians noong 3000 BC. They are looking for something where they can write their documents without being erased or smudged and to improve their writing material for longer use. Ang pinakang common po na ano neto, yung mga scroll po, yung mga, kung alam niyo po yung sa mga palabas na sinauna, yun po.
Again, the title is Papyrus Invented by?
Egyptians po.
Egyptians. Good. Next. Thank you, Miss Beatrice. Next.
Sir, ako po.
Yan.
Sir.
Yan.
Ayan, yes. Kita po.
Yes, Miss Marquez.
So ito po yung ano, is ancient Egyptian wig invented by Egyptian po. It is discovered in 2700 BCE. So bakit nga daw po, so bakit po ginawa ang wig? So wigs are part of daily lives in ancient Egypt. Most Egyptians shaved their heads to be more comfortable from the hot climate and also to prevent infestation of lice. So ano po, bakit po nagkaroon ng ng problema. So, however, it appears that Egyptians preferred having hair, which resulted to the creation of wigs. So, ayun nga daw po yung problema. Mas nagustuhan po ng mga Egyptians na magkaroon ng buhok. Kaya na-invent po yung wig. So, in ancient Egypt, wigs can be used as an alternative hair, and it also indicates personal status in life. So, ayun po yung purpose ng wigs in ancient Egypt. Yun lang po, sir. Thank you po.
Again, the invention is...
Wig po, sir. Apo, Egyptians po. In 2700 BCE.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you po.
Next, let's proceed to the Middle Ages.
Yung chosen ano ko po, yung chosen Middle Age invention ko po is the magnetic compass. It was first discovered by the Chinese, but Alexander Neckam reinvented it. Wait lang. Reinvented it. Tapos po, it was invented on 1190 BCE, and it is used for navigation to find direction on Earth. It was also used by Chinese for fortune telling and also used for sea travel in 11th century. Yun po.
Again, what's the invention? It's magnetic compass by?
Apo. Alexander Neckam po.
Alexander Neckam. Good. Next. Thank you.
Sir, ako, sir, ako sir. Po. Sir, ako sir.
Sige. Pakita lang kayo sa screen.
Sino ba nauna?
Yan. Elaine.
Sir, yes sir.
Sige.
Good evening everyone. I'm going to present to you one of the invention that is created during Middle Age, hourglass. Ayan po. Hourglass was also known as sand clock. It was invented by a French monk, Lutprand, in 8th century Age of Discovery. Hourglass is an early device used to measure the interval of time. It is an ideal device uses for to travel the world with the use of ships because it keeps an accurate time at the sea. It also records a minute or half minute increases of time to measure the patient's pulse. Ang history po ng hourglass is that dati po yung since it wasn't possible in middle age po na mag-travel ng ano ng true sea, yung nag-try po sila na gumamit ng dalawang method, yung water clock at saka yung candle clock, pero naging useless po yung dalawa na yon kasi po yung water clock hindi po steady yung center niya kapag nagte-travel po sa ocean. Then yung candle clock naman po palagi pong namamatay tsaka palagi po siya nagpo-point sa north. Then yung impact po nung hourglass sa during middle age is that since yung mariners po back then is nagte-travel po sila or uses landmarks and memorization and guessing to travel the world, yung hourglass po is yung naging way para mas mapadali po yung pag-travel nila vice versa po sa iba't iba pong country during middle age. Yun lang po sir. Hourglass po by invented by Lutprand in 8th century po. Thank you po.
Invented by whom again? Sorry. Elaine.
Lutprand po. Lutprand. Lutprand.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you po.
Next.
Sir, ako po. Janea po. I-drawing yung printing press. Ayan.
Okay.
Printing press po. Invented by Jonas Gutenberg.
Johannes Gutenberg.
Date po ng yung date po na inenvento po tong printing press is 1440s. Ito po. Yung purpose po ng printing press is a machine that allows for the mass production of uniform printed matters, images, mainly text in the form of books, pamphlets, and newspaper that transferred by means of ink. Yung ano, meron po siyang advantage at disadvantage. Yung advantage niya po, offers good color that essentially print neon colors and standard colors, also provide by including foil stamping and die cutting. Yung ano naman po niya, disadvantages po ng printing press is maintaining a large press machine can be expensive. Next, time consuming and pollution issues. Ito po yung ano, yung printing press.
Okay, the invention again is printing press by Johannes Gutenberg. Okay, thank you. Oh, next.
Sir, ito po yung drawing po. Kita nyo
po. Yan.
Apo, catapults po by Dionysus the Elder of Sicarus po. It was invented po by Dionysus the Elder of Sicarus who was invented and developed the new catapult about 400 BCE po. So, catapults is a mechanism to forcefully propelling stones, spears, or other projectiles in used military weapons since ancient time. The Greek and Romans used a heavily crossbow-like weapon known as balistes to shoot arrow and darts as well as stones as enemy soldier. So, ayun po, sir. Ginagamit po nila is yung bato po or yung parang arrow po para patamaan po yung kalaban po. Lalo na po ginagamit po to lalo na po sa mga tore po. Parang ganun po. Si sir, kinakabahan ako.
Ikaw lang mag-isa na andyan, kinakabahan ka pa.
Hindi po sir, kasi nasa ibang bahay lang po ako.
Nasa ibang bahay
lang? Naka lang po ako. Apo. So, okay. Ayan po.
Catapult invented by?
Dionysius the Elder of Sicarus po, sir.
Patingin niya na spelling. Nakikita niyo class? Inventor?
Hindi po. Hindi po, sir.
Paki-message yung inventor, ha? Para mabilis.
Sige po.
O, next.
Sige po, sir. Mamaya po.
Sir, okay na po. Nakikita na po ako.
Okay, kita ka na namin. Sige.
Ito po. Ito po yung akin.
Ah, okay.
Ito po yung eyeglasses and spectacles po. Historians are not certain who invented the first spectacles or eyeglasses. Okay. Mid 13th century, around 1287, painting first appeared with people wearing and holding spectacles. From this painting, we know that spectacles were invented. Nasabi rin po, kaya po na-invento yung eyeglasses, it helped us to see better and help people with eye problems or bad sight to see clearer. With this invention, human would have hard time to read and see things. Millions of people of eyeglasses have been developed into sunglasses, contact lenses with fashion trends. Tsaka rin po sa akin, ano daw po, yun daw po na-invento yung printing press, mas marami daw pong bumili ng books at may mas marami pong kumailangan ng eyeglasses. Ayun lang po.
Again, eyeglasses invented by?
Wala pong sinabi kasi sabi lang po dito, hindi daw po alam kung sino daw po naka-invented ng eyeglasses, pero po sa Egypt daw po ito nagsimula.
Started in Egypt. Okay, sige. Thank you.
Thank you po.
Okay, start Miss Annabelle. Sige.
Ito po ay na-invento po ito ni a Chinese general, Zhuge Liang po. It was invented on 280. This is the wheelbarrow. The wheelbarrow is a used transport supplies injured soldiers. The name is wheelbarrow wooden ox. Pinangalanan din niya po yung invention niya na wooden ox. And nakatulong po ito ng malaki dahil po nasa war sila, mas mabilis po nilang nahahatid yung pagkain at mga gamot po dahil po dito sa wheelbarrow. Sa pangalan na rin po mismo, wooden ox po yung pinangalan niya dito, ibig sabihin po, made din po siya sa wood. Yan po. Meron din po siya, makikita niyo po, isa lang po yung wheel niya, and then may support wood po dito sa gitna, and then may dalawa pong handle po doon. Yun lang po, sir.
Okay, again, the invention is wheelbarrow invented by?
Zhuge Liang po. Chinese general, Zhuge Liang. Okay na po.
Thank you. Next.
Thank you, sir.
Sir. Okay. Sir.
Sige.
Nakikita mo, sir?
Yes.
Sa akin po, ano, liquor or alcohol. It was invented po noong 13th century. Pero yung inventor po, wala pong specific na naka-invento. Pero may nabanggit po doon na Arab alchemist na si Al-Kindi. Tapos, yung purpose po nitong liquor sa Middle Age ay, ano po, they says that distilled alcohol is a cure for ailment such as cholera. Tsaka, sir, ito din ay, ano, naging purpose din ito, sir, sa digestion po. Lang, sir.
Okay, again, the invention is liquor by... Saan nag-originate ang
si alcohol? Ano po, si Al. Pinakilala lang siya, sir, sa Europe, 13th century.
Next, thank you. Modern period.
Thank you, sir.
Sige.
Sorry po, pangit drawing ko. Windmill. Windmill was invented in 1854 in Middle Ages. Windmill, also known as wind power grain mills. It is invented by Daniel Holliday. Windmill were used to harness the power of the wind, and the inside of them is where the grain was ground up. The first windmill was manufactured in the United States. It has 5 parts, which is blades, generator, tower, batteries, and wind power site. Yun lang po.
Windmill invented by?
Daniel Holliday po.
It's Daniel Holliday. Right, good. Next, thank you, Miss Manundo.
Ako po, sir.
Sige.
Sa modern.
Modern. So now we are now in the modern.
Kita po ba?
Yes, telephone.
Telephone po. Telephone, Greek word, telephone, invented by Alexander Graham Bell. Yeah, on October 18, 1892, an instrument designed for the simultaneous transmission and reception of the human voice. The telephone is inexpensive, is simple to operate, and offers its users an immediate, personal type of communication that cannot be obtained through any other medium. As a result, it has become the most widely used telecommunication device, and the billions of telephones are in used around the world. Telephone's pros and cons. Advantage. Most people have a telephone. No specialist equipment is needed. Disadvantage. It is not easy to make a record of what is said during the call. Things might be forgotten or misinterpreted. Yun lang po, sir.
Okay, again, it's telephone invented by?
Alexander Graham Bell.
It's Alexander Graham Bell. Good. Thank you. Next. Jugal Nonay.
Ito po, sir.
Yes, electronic television.
Electronic television, invented by fellow T. Farnsworth, date September 7, 1927. Television, also known as a TV, is a machine with a screen, receive broadcasting signal and change them into pictures and sounds. The word television came from Greek word tele for far away and vision for sight. Sometimes a television can look like a box. The purpose of television is to illuminate and to entertain. And the function of television is to transmitting visual image and sound that are produced on screen used to broadcast program for entertainment, information, and education. Yun po, sir.
Again, the invention is television by?
Pelletier Franceworth po.
Okay po. Quadrant and astrolabe po. Astrolabes are calculation instrument that enable their users to tell the time and determine their geographical latitude using the position of the sun and stars, and is an extremely rare instrument. Astrolabe is one of the only eight such instruments to have survived from the Middle Age. Invented in the Hellenistic civilization by Apollonius of Perga between 220 and 150 BC. Yun lang po, sir.
What's the invention again? It's astrolabe by?
Si ano, wala, ano pong sinabi? Invented in Hellenistic civilization by Apollonius by Perga of Perga po. Middle po ako, sir.
Ah, middle ka pa rin.
Sir. Middle age. Opo, hindi lang po ako makasingit kanina po kasi po nagsisipasok na po yung mga modern.
Ah, okay. Sige. Middle talaga yan. Sige. Thank you.
Apo. Thank you po.
Next, modern.
Punta sa akin. Ang title po niya ay Airplane. Ang inventors po ay si Wilbur and Orville Wright, known as the Wright Brothers. So, on December 17, 1903, Wilbur and Orville Wright made four brief flights at Kitty Hawk with their first powered aircraft. Naging successful po ang kanilang mga unang paglipad dahil gumawa po sila at nag-develop ng concept na tinatawag nilang wing warping. Ito po yung in-observe po nila kung paano po kontrolin o i-balance ng isang ibon ang kanyang sarili habang nasa himpapawid. Tapos, ang reason po ng Wright brother kung bakit po nila ginawa ang airplane ay dahil gusto po nilang malaman kung paano i-balance ng isang piloto ang isang aircraft gaya po ng pagbalanse ng isang siklista sa kanyang bisikleta. So, yung purpose naman po ng aircraft ay ng airplane ay to move people and cargo from one place to another. Meron din po siyang different types na naka according po siya sa may bawat mission po ng aircraft. Kung ito ba gagamitin sa digmaan, meron po tayong fighter aircraft at kung gagamitin naman po siya sa pagda-transfer po ng mga cargo aircraft po. Tapos meron din po siyang four important forces. Ito po yung thrust, yung lift, yung weight at saka yung drag. Yun lang po.
Okay, thank you. It's Airplane by Wright Brothers. Next.
By Wright Brothers.
It's Wright Brothers. Next.
A pleasant evening, everyone. Okay, so this is the invention that I chose from the modern period. Okay, so this is car that is invented by Carl Benz. So there is a very long history on how car was invented, but the closest one to what we are using right now is what Carl Benz invented. So Carl Benz patented the three-wheel motor car, also known as the motor wagon, in 1886. A car is a four-wheeled vehicle that is used for transportation. Its main purpose is to transport people from one place to another. It is also sometimes used by people to deliver goods. Cars made traveling on land a lot easier and faster. So this is one of the examples of the modern car that we are using today. Thank you.
Okay, so again, the invention is car by Carl Benz. Okay, thank you. Next, modern.
Sir?
Wala na. Oh, yun. Sige.
Okay na po. Yung invention po na napili ko is radar. Radar is invented in 1924 by Edward Appleton. Radar also stands for Radio Detection and Ranging System. A device or system consisting usually a synchronized radio transmitter and receiver that emits radio wave process, the reflection for display, and is used especially for detecting, locating objects such as aircraft or surface features or a terrain. Ayun na po, sir.
Again, the invention is radar by?
Edward Appleton.
It's Edward Appleton. Okay, thank you. Next.
Ito po, yung invention ko po is camera. The Kodak camera was invented in 1888 by George Eastman. It was a simple handed box camera containing 100 exposure roll of film that used paper negatives. So, George Eastman developed this camera that has become a big impact in society. It gives us the ability to capture picture by the click of a button and to develop the memories that were captured. The camera has changed the way we see and document the world around us. So, ito po, sir, yung camera by George Eastman po.
Okay, thank you. Camera next.
Tapos na po.
Modern.
Ako po, sir. Ang ano ko po ay radio po by Guglielmo Marconi. Radio is a linear medium. The selection process takes place in a studio and the listener is presented with a single thread of material. Radio has foundation of time and lack of space. It can allow less space to advertisement and personal announcement than paper. The prime purpose of radio is to convey information from one place to another through intervening media. In other words, air, space, non-conducting materials without wires. Besides being used for transmitting sound and television signals, it is used for transmission of data in coded form. Our primary function are to educate, inform, and entertain. Ayun lang po, sir.
What's the invention again?
Transatlantic telegram po. Kung tinatawag po ngayon ay radio.
Radio. Invented by?
Guglielmo Marconi.
It's Marconi.
Sir, ako po.
Ayan. Sige.
Nakikita niyo po, sir.
Yes.
This was discovered in 1895 by Wilhelm Conrad Roentgen, who was a professor at Wittenberg University. An X-ray is a common imaging test that's been used for decades. It can help your doctor view the inside of your body without having to make an incision. This can help them diagnose, monitor, and treat many medical conditions. X-ray can be used to examine most areas of the body. They're mainly used to look at the bones and joints, although they're sometimes used to detect problems affecting soft tissue, such as internal organs. Problems that may be detected during an X-rays include bone fractures and breaks. Info.
X-ray invented by?
Wilhelm Conrad Roentgen po. Conrad Roentgen. Malabo.
Next.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sir, ako po, sir.
Sige.
Sir, ako po, sir.
Sige, Jerwin.
Ano po, sir? Email po.
Okay.
Email. Ito po yung email.
Sige.
Ayan po. Bye. Ano ba ito? Wait lang po, sir. Email po by Ray Tomlinson po.
Sige.
Invented in 1960s po. Method of exchanging digital message between people over a network. Electronic mails or email is a method of exchanging message or mail between people using electronic device. Email entered limited use in the 1960s, but user could only send to user of the same computer. And some early email system required the author and recipients to debut the online similitus newsly. Similar to instant messaging. Ayun lang po, sir.
Okay, thank you, Jerwin.
Salamat po.
Next, who would like to start? Philippine Invention.
Good evening, everyone.
Sige.
Good evening, everyone. So, this is my illustration. And as you can see, it is a picture or includes a man wearing what we called the bahag. So bahag is also known for the term loincloth, L-O-I-N, cloth. Bahag is a one-piece garment that looks like a belt covering the genitals and the buttocks of the person. So for the inventor, Actually, wala po akong nakita na specific person, ay specific name of the person behind this invention. Pero base po sa mga result, sa mga information na nakalap ko, ang naka-invento raw po nito is yung mga indigenous tribes po na, ng Cordilleran in Northern Luzon. And time it was invented, na-invento po siya around 19th century. Bahag is made from the bark of trees and the dried banana stalk. So there are some instances na yung mga babae po daw sa tribe na yon, nakakabili na daw po sila ng mga dirty white threads, and dahil po dito, nagagawa na po nilang tahiin yung mga materials na iyon. And ang process po sa pagtatahi na yon ay ang tinatawag po nating backstrap weaving. Functions po nito ng pagsuot ng bahag, of course, para po matakpan yung ibang parts po ng body ng isang tao, and also ginagamit po siya for special occasions, and it also serves as a pocket kasi kadalasan po sa mga lalaki po sa tribo, naglalagay po sila ng mga tools, for example, knives dito po sa bandang waist nila. And also, wearing this kind of bahag, nagiging essential po siya as a basis para malaman po yung level of status as well as yung social class po ng isang tao within the community. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Good evening, po.
Sige.
This is the 10 Mbit internet CMOS invented. This is the 10 Mbit internet CMOS with silicon coupler data link control and trans receiver chip invented and discovered by Diosdado Vanatau. He was interested on how to make PC faster, so therefore, in 1981, he developed the first 10 Mbit internet CMOS while working at CE Technology. At ang purpose po nito ay first system logic chipset for IMSNP, PCXT, and PC80 desktop computer. Parang ito po yung naging pinaka parang innovation po ng mga chipset po natin ng computer ngayon. Yung pinakasimulan po. Yun lang po.
Okay, again, the invention Gene Bert is microchip by?
Diosdado Vanatau po.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir.
Yan.
Kita po.
Kita.
Yan, sir. Yung Philippine invention po is Quink Ink, was invented by Francisco Kisumbing. So it was invented or introduced way back 1931. Tapos ito pong Quink Ink, it is a classic ink used for dip and fountain pens. And then high quality and smooth ink used for illustration and painting. It is a beautiful medium na gagamitin po para sa classroom kasi quicker and easier po siya sa pagsusulat. Yun po, again, Quink Ink by Francisco Kisumbing. Yun po, sir. Welcome po.
Next.
Sir, ako pong next.
Sige.
Ita po.
Yes.
Pili ko po ay video phone po. Video phone. Video phone, also called as two-way television telephone, was invented by a Filipino engineer and a physicist, Gregorio Y. Zara, in 1955. Video phone patented as a photophone signal separator network. Mr. Gregorio Zara invented a device that simultaneously transmits and receives both audio and video signals over telephone lines. It is a device that makes it possible for two persons to see each other on a television while talking on the telephone. Yan po yung purpose niya, bakit ginawa po si video phone, sir. A video phone is a device also that assists deaf and hard of hearing people who use sign language in communicating with others. In such cases, the interpreter, called a video interpreter, communicates with the deaf person using sign language and relays the information to the hearing person by speaking the message. Yun lang po, sir.
Okay, it's video.
Again po, ang invention niya ay Gregorio Y. Zara po, on 1955.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, yung iba po naming classmate hindi po makakamit.
Okay lang yan.
Sir, ako lang po.
Sige.
Good evening po, sir. Ang napili ko pong invention is Philippine Jeepney. Leonardo Salvador Sarao Sr. was the founder and owner of the Sarao Motors. The jeepney invented was 1945 up to present. A Sarao jeepney was exhibited at the Philippine Pavilion at the year of 1964 New York World's Fair as the national image for Filipino. Jeepneys was known as the king of the road because of their bulky box type of frame and because of the notorious way that drivers would nestle their way in and out of traffic. Jeepney is an affordable mode of Philippine public transport and it was stretched long enough to accommodate around 15 to 25 passengers. It was originated from U.S. military, where the earliest origin of the jeepney is from Austin 7, which also one of the precursors of the jeep. This arrived in the Philippines at the beginning of World War II. The jeepney is likely a portmanteau word, a combination of jeep and jeepney. Both words are common slang in the popular vernacular of the era. Jeepney being a popular term for an American taxi cab. Sir.
It's not invented by, it's improved by Sarau. Okay, thank you. Miss Christine, next.
Sir, ako po.
Sige.
The title of invention is erythromycin. Erythromycin is a broad-spectrum macrolide antibiotic with antibacterial activity. The inventor of erythromycin is Dr. Abelardo Aguilar. It was invented in 1952. The purpose or use of it is used to treat a wide variety of bacterial infections. Again, the invention is erythromycin, invented by Dr. Abelardo Aguilar.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Wala na?
Sir, meron pa po.
Ah, sige.
Si Rosenta po.
Okay, sige.
So, yung invention po, yung name po ng invention, Salamander Amphibious Tricycle, invented by Victor Atol Yave from H2O Technology. Yung date po ng it was invented, 2015 po. But I'm not sure po kung 2015, but based on my research, yung lumalabas sa page ng H2O Technologies po, kung kailan nila na-register ay 2015 po. Kaya ilagay ko po sa 20. It can transform from traveling on land to traveling in water in a matter of seconds. The purpose is to serve as a rescue vehicle in the event of flooding. It can carry 6 passengers, including the driver, that can drive over land and water direct. The first ever Pinoy designed and engineered a tricycle vehicle took 5 years to develop. So, kaya po siya na-invento. Kaya nga po dito sa Pilipinas. Prone po tayo sa flood. Kaya po naisip nila yung gantong tricycle. Yun. Again po, ano, Salamander Amphibious Tricycle invented by Victor Atol Yave from H2O Technology.
Okay. Thank you. Next. Okay, kung wala na, sige, labas lahat ng camera. Okay, so next meeting, inform din yung other classmates nyo na hindi naka-attend today. Okay? Ipo-post ko siya today. Tonight pala. I'll post the recorded video tonight para mapag-aralan niyo mabuti. Sige, kung wala na, ingat kayo dyan. Bye-bye. Ingat kayo.
Thank you.
Thank you po, sir.
Thank you, sir.